Hi! Guess you figured out what we're going to talk about right now, because all of this decoration, if that was not clue enough, like this gargoyle from the Addams family, this goose egg from famous fairy tales by Hans Christian Andersen. Joking! We are talking about Game of Thrones!
Yay! So, this year, we'll see the finale, the grand finale of HBO's most successful TV show that has held our imaginations captive for the last 8 seasons. And now that it is ending, and Georgie Boy is still not writing the 6th book of A Song of Ice and Fire, there, it's fine. We thought we'll come up with a list of books that are companion novels for A Song of Ice and Fire series that help you stay in the
Ice and Fire universe. These are all books that are written, that have stories based in the universe. Yes. And that will help you learn more, so that when you're at a party and there are people who read the books and watch the TV show and are feeling superior, you can be like,
I know more,
because I read all these other books as well, and I'm fucking smarter than you. You know why dragons, you know why the doom of Valyria happened, bitch?
I know why, bitch. I know why. I know how the throne was made.
So, I mean, you know, we are all going to be facing this time where there will be no more Game of Thrones in our life. And yeah. What we can do, of course, is wear a blanket and walk around looking worried and pretend we are Jon Snow. Or we can read all of these novels.
Mm-hmm.
Without further ado, let's get into them.
So book number one, of course, I'm going to start with the prequels because they're also going to be turned into a TV show soon. So let's talk about A Knight of the Seven Kingdoms, written by George R. R. Martin. Now, The Knight of the Seven Kingdoms is the story of Sir Duncan the Tall, who goes on to become the Lord Commander of the Kingsguard, and his squire, a special boy named Egg, whose full name is Aegon Targaryen, who is Maester Aemon's brother and the Mad King Aerys' grandfather. So these it's a set of 3 novellas written by George R. R. Martin, and it tracks the journey of Sir Duncan from when he was just a squire and a hedge knight to him becoming the Lord Commander of the Kingsguard. And of course, it gives us an insight into the life of the Targaryens before the series, 90 years before the show, the stuff that happens in the show happens. Mm-hmm. So it actually, I loved reading it because it was after such a long time that I read something that was set in Westeros that had already made me happy. But also because these stories have an almost fairy tale-like charm to them, as opposed to, you know, Game of Thrones, which begins only with Bran being tossed out the window.
Like and, King Arthur type.
Yeah, there is gore and there is all of that is there, that standard Game of Thrones, George R. R. Martin stuff. But in the beginning, it feels like it's a fairy tale, like it's a fantasy. And I love that about this book. So. If you like Eyes of Fire, you should have read this by now, but if you haven't, there is no reason for you to not read it. It's amazing. Pick it up. Everything you love about it is replicated. Tales of Duncan Egg.
The next book is one that I haven't read, but I'm thinking it's going to be interesting because it's
you
from
have
the
read it.
Collection.
If you've read the Game of Thrones, the Eyes of Fire series, this is that only. It's just an extension. It's the wit and wisdom of Tyrion Lannister.
The wit and wisdom of Tyrion Lannister. It's basically all his quotable quotes from all the books compiled in one nice quote book. And essentially, it's a perfect, I think, party gift to give anybody who's a fan of the Game of Thrones series and don't want to, like, necessarily read all this. This is just a great, like, companion novel to have. Because you can, like, literally just, like, turn any chapter and
read one.
Like, so the one that I picked out was, we've had vicious kings and we've had idiot kings. But I don't know if we've ever been cursed with a vicious idiot boy king. I think it's a great comment on our current times also. But anyway, let that be aside. It's a great illustrated code book and you should pick it up.
I love it. Book number 3 is called The World of Ice and Fire. So it's sort of like a companion novel to The World. It illustrates everything from the Doom of Valyria to Doom Again, Come Away With Me on a Roller Coaster Ride.
Come Away With Me.
So basically, the origin story of all the great houses, how far back does the Targaryen clan go, where do they come back? Of course, there's another book that delves into that. But this book was written by Elio Garcia and Linda Antonsson in collaboration with George R. R. Martin. Now, they started what is considered the premier fan community for A Song of Ice and Fire called Westeros.org.
It's better
these
than two. The Song of Ice and Fire wiki.
Wiki, yeah. It's way better. Yeah. And even George R. R. Martin recognized their efforts, and so he asked them to prepare this guide, which is the world itself, and then he took over and then he filled out all the gaps, and then he basically they gleaned all the information from the existing books, and then George R. R. Martin took over to make it rounded, wholesome. And so it's your beginner's guide to the world, to Westeros and the world of Ice and Fire outside Westeros, also ASOs, everything.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
And it's like a beginning, what's the word for it? It's a dipstick of all the great houses, and it's amazing. It's so good. You're just like,
yeah.
Oh, this is, and it's written from the point, like it's like a maester is writing it to document it. So it's lovely. It's pure fun, pure unadulterated Ice and Fire fun.
Keeping in tune with Anoya's book recommendation, my recommendation is the book called Fire and Blood, written by George R. R. Martin. And I heard the audiobook version of it, which is narrated by Simon Wands. Now, Fire and Blood is the story of the Targaryens, as like my cup can tell you. The Targaryens are my favorite house from the Westeros world, only because there is magic in it and they have dragons and then the dragon lords, and then they were the only house to survive the doom of Valyria. And then how Aegon the First with his sisters flew from Dragonstone to King's Landing and then captured the entire six kingdoms of the seven, and how they did it, and how there was a civil war that erupted between the Targaryens and
the Blackfyre Rebellion.
The Blackfyre Rebellion. And then the first, and it also really talks about the mythology of the dragons, where they came from, what the Doom of Valyria was, and how, why it was so harmful for the dragons, and also how the dragons devolved over a period of time. Like it says that the first dragons were really large, as big as ships, and then the last dragons, when the Mad King took over, were as small as cats. So it's basically their degeneration. And it's also written in the voice of Archmeister Gladen, who narrates the story as like a sequence of events. There is a sequel coming to this book, because these are only the first three Aegons. And like, if you have read anything on the Song of Ice and Fire, you will know there are many Aegons.
Yeah.
So ye to abhi teen hi hue hain.
Unka naam Aegon kyun hai? They are never gone. एक मर गया तो एगॉन आ जाएगा. ओके, आई एम नाउ गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट व्हाट आई थिंक इज द मोस्ट फन बुक, व्हिच इज कॉल्ड अ फीस्ट ऑफ आइस एंड फायर. नाउ फीस्ट ऑफ आइस एंड फायर केम फ्रॉम दिस ब्लॉग कॉल्ड इन एट द क्रॉसरोड्स, व्हिच बिकॉज जॉर्ज आर मार्टिन इज सो गुड विथ हिज डिस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ फूड एंड फैशन बाय द वे, बट आई डोंट नो व्हाई नोबडी हैज डन दैट येट, बट he really goes into each dish and tells you what's in it and how it tastes and all. And I remember, I think, Joffrey's wedding, where they have 77 courses.
Pigeon pie, man.
Yeah, yeah. So what these guys do is they rescue you from pigeon pie and lemon cake-itis. Yeah, by telling you how to make them one at a time. So you don't make 77 courses and eat them all. But they take recipes, they take food that comes, dishes from the book, and give you recipes for how to make them. And then they have published, so the blog exists, and this book has been an amalgamation, a result of that blog, called Feast of Ice and Fire, which takes the best recipes, and is now called the official cookbook of the Ice and Fire series.
So the next book is actually an anthology of short stories, which we only discovered like about a year ago.
Yeah.
And we're like, what the fuck, why don't we know about this? It's called Rogues, and it has short stories by all these fabulous writers like Gillian Flynn and
Neil Gaiman
and
Joe Abercrombie. Yes. Lots of famous names from fiction and fantasy.
Exactly. And
have come
it has
together.
A story set in Westeros, written by George R. R. Martin for the Rogue series. So these are like short stories you won't forget anywhere but in this book.
And he's edited and compiled them with the help of another author named Gardner, Dozois. They've also written another, there's another one like these called Dangerous
Books.
Women.
No,
Dangerous Women. And that also has a Game of Thrones story. So basically, you see anything written by George R. R. Martin that could have a short story by in the Game of Thrones world, just get it.
Who do you guys think were the most dangerous women in Game of Thrones? Tell us in the comment section below.
All of them.
Don't say Cersei, or that we know.
But all of them. But yes, let us know in the comment section.
Mm-hmm. So the next book is Game of Thrones, A Psychology of the Characters. It's written by a psychologist called Travis Langley. And it's called The Mind is Dark and Full of Terrors.
That's a great name. It's a great name.
So what he does is he picks apart all the characters in the book and then he tries to like define what, you know, issues they might have in the book.
Ye bipolar hai, wo psychopath hai, wo aisa, maza aayega, achha hai. The last book that I'm going to talk about, I mean, it's not really something you can read, but I love it.
You can do
okay?
it.
Yeah, you can do it. Wish I could do Jon Snow. Anyway, it's the Game of Thrones adult coloring books, and basically they are sketches from the books. Of course, you know that there are also Game of Thrones graphic novels, but those are really expensive, guys. But if you feel like it, you can get them, of course. So, the coloring books are black and white sketches of scenes from all the books. Great scenes, very well drawn, and it's supposed to be an act of mindfulness to sit and color them because they're very intricate.
Yeah,
I love them because you can literally like stab Joffrey with a pencil, like bhadas nikal sakte hai puri us kitab pe. So it's like watching Game of Thrones. So it's like watching Game of Thrones, but also involving yourself in the story and also sort of gaining some sort of calm and peace.
Wow, that is not what happened
with the books or the show. So this is the antidote to watching Game of Thrones, the adult coloring books.
So there it is. These are great books and devices to stay within the A Song of Ice and Fire universe and to make sure that you always think that the night is dark and full of terrors. Never forget that. And winter is always coming. Never forget that.
Yeah.
All the books mentioned in the video are listed in our description box below with links for you to buy them. You can either read them or you can listen to them.
On the Storytel app. Yeah. And if you download the Storytel app by going to the link that we are putting up here, which is bit.ly/botstorytel, you get only you, not everybody, just you, get access to the unlimited books for 30 days for free. Free, guys. So do that. Listen to Fire and Blood and all the other gorgeous Game of Thrones books that are there. And then come and join us for our next discussion on Game of Thrones because it's coming. Winter has come.
Winter has come.
And we know.
Save the dragon.
We know that Jon Snow is Azor Uddin, savior of the Indian cricket team. He's going to fight the White Walkers, which is basically
coming
British
from Pakistan.
Teams. Nahi re, Brit in white test.
Ah, oh, wow.